Five simple ways to increase email open rates. Some of them you might be surprised, and some meaning you might feel, wow, I didn't know that. Why haven't we been doing that? Let's do that tomorrow. First thing is pick the best time to send your email. And I love this little infographic from GetResponse. It really, you know, they did a lot of research, and I'll show you the conclusion on the next slide, but they really walk you through this. This is a very donor-centric view of email, right? So at 5 p.m., people are stuck in traffic, right? We've all been there. 6 p.m., people are ordering pizza. If you have kids, hopefully they're not eating pizza every night, but you're maybe making a quick, good meal, but at 6 o'clock, you're very busy. 7 o'clock, bathing the kids. 8 o'clock, then they are back to email. Okay, so now 4 hours after delivery, the chance of opening a newsletter is decreased to less than 5%. So the idea is that in theory, at the top, it says, in theory, an email sent to 5 p.m. has a huge chance, 23% chance of being opened within the first hour. But because, you know, a couple of hours go by and they get busy and all this other stuff, they get to email, and you and I have done this. We get to email, we select a few emails that have come in the past 3 or 4 hours. We don't really want to read them, delete. So pick the best time. What is the best time? They found that 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock in the morning are actually the top open rates and click rates. And then the PM is 3 o'clock and 8 o'clock and then 4, which is kind of interesting because when you think about it, people might get emails, they click on, they open them at 3, but some of those emails, they might say, okay, you know, great, I'll look at this later, okay? So 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, maybe they open the email, but then 8 o'clock at night, remember? After all the kids are out of the bath, they're in bed, and our superhero is back checking email. Right? So that's the first thing. Second thing is you want to send the email from someone that the subscriber knows. And HubSpot did some really interesting research, and they found that when the sender, which most email marketing tools out there, you can edit the sender. You know, who is this email from? The sender field. When they personalize it, it looks like there's a huge increase in open rate. Well, not a huge increase, but there's, you know, a significant increase in open rate and click-through rate. So this is something that you can do pretty easily and test out different senders. Okay, so for example, you know, it says right here, make sure the subscriber knows the sender, your organization. It could be your organization, it could be a spokesperson representing your organization, or it could be a campaign, like in this example right here. All of these emails, by the way, in this screenshot, these are all from one, literally one email address, info@barackobama.com. And the sender, they're editing the sender depending upon the campaign. And so they, you know, you can look up the Obama email marketing strategy. There's a lot of information out there, but one factor was that helped their success was, you know, changing the sender to make it really, really relevant to both the message and the receiver. Okay. Number three, create donor focused triggered messages. And what does that mean? The research on the right, basically the green line going across the top of the light blue line or whatever color you want to call this, it's really speaking about open rate. And what's the difference between this line, this blue line, and this black line right here? Okay, you probably can't read it. I'll just explain what it is. Okay, so these are email blasts that go out. And these are triggered messages, okay? And this is the percent of open rate, 11% for your email blast, whereas 50 to 55% open rate on triggered messages. A triggered message is a message, an email message that goes out after someone subscribes, after becoming an email subscriber, after making a donation, okay? They take an action, they make a donation, after signing a petition, after participating in a photo contest or a sweepstakes, or logging into their membership. So obviously the message is going to be different for each situation, but we can see on the right, the open rate is just tremendous, okay? So if someone becomes a subscriber, an email subscriber, or if someone signs a petition, you want to follow up with an email. What's going to be the next action after signing a petition? It might be making a very small donation, but recency is critical. Okay, recency is critical. You want to follow up with people quickly. That's why you want triggered messages. You don't want to just get people who sign a petition and then 2 or 3 days later, you decide, okay, we're just going to send an email blast to these people. That's not going to be as effective as setting up a triggered message that gets sent to the person signing the petition. And the email simply says, thanks for signing the petition. We're making a big change in the world because of you. And here's what else you can do. Okay, we need help today. If we hit this goal, we get a match, whatever the situation is, click here to make a donation. Okay, so right out of the gate, you've got a huge increase in open rate right here. It says 50% open rate on these triggered email messages. Use social media to announce when you send an email. So when you send an email out, you can send out a tweet or an update on Facebook, something like that, to say, hey, our email newsletter's out. That way people who get that update, they can go to their email and open it, okay? They get it on Twitter, they see that on Twitter, they go to their email, they might open it, they might be curious. Especially if you're posting stuff like, you're not gonna believe the amazing story in this week's newsletter, check it out. And then obviously, if you're not subscribed, click here to fix that. Okay, so definitely do these three things. Send out a tweet or an update. Give a teaser to people. This is what's this is what's going to be amazing in this newsletter. You're not going to believe it. Create a question in their mind that causes them to at least be interested in reading that email, right? Include a link in the tweet or the Facebook update or the post on Pinterest or Instagram. Include a link to your subscribe page, because many people who see that content will not be email subscribers. Okay, so we're talking about two things here, increasing the open rate and growing your email list. Okay, works well with organizations, especially who have an active following on Twitter and Facebook. It's a really great way to kind of build up the email subscribers. So that's number four. So subject lines, make a strong value statement, free download, incentive to register early, and there are just a few examples on the right. Make it urgent, examples on the right-hand side, petitions, deadlines, scarcity. Scarcity is a big thing that does kind of generate urgency. You know, we only have 3 or 4 seats left in the balcony. You have to come to our show next week. Don't miss out. And then use power words like these strong kind of statements. As we can see, these examples on the right, you know, there's a what in my couch. I don't know if I would personally would open that one, but I might be curious. Actually, you know what? I probably would open that email, to be honest with you. There's something in my couch. I mean, I might just read it. I may not click through the message, but at least I'll open it. Okay. And then also you want to make the message curious, like subject line. That's our topic here. Make it curious. Tell half the story. So a couple of examples on the right. This is bad. Okay. Again, Barack Obama. Come on, Barack. Don't leave me hanging. What are you talking about? This is bad. Pink has a new color. What? Wait, hang on. Pink is already a color, but there's a new, I don't understand. I have to figure that out. Make it personal. If you could put the first name in the email subject line, that might work. Don't push this too far, though, because it could come across as gimmicky or manipulative. So just be really careful how you use a first name in an email, right? Don't use it too much or in too many places that feel unnatural. You don't want to have every other sentence end with comma John, for example. All right. And that is it. So I'm just going to jump back up here. I'm going to exit.